Dzień dobry Państwu. Chciałbym się podzielić z Wami moimi rozważaniami o
Hello, ladies and
architekturze,
gentlemen.
sztuce
I'd like to
i
share with
istocie
you
muzeum.
my observations concerning architecture, art, and the essence of the museum.
Obserwując rzeczywistość, można odnieść
When
wrażenie, że
observing
całość jest
reality,
zbudowana
we
na
may get an
kłamstwie.
impression that the whole
Tylko w
world is built on
1958
lies. Le
roku
Corbusier,
napisał o
in a
współczesnej
letter
sztuce
of 1908,
klasę
wrote
słowa,
about
kiedy
his
ten
teacher, Charles
poczerniony jesteście
Lepagnier.
zakochani. Ponieważ nie wiecie,
You are
czym architektura jest
hypocritical because
naprawdę.
you do not know what architecture
Może w tym pytaniu
is.
było trochę prawdy.
So why should
Dlaczego
architects
dla
also not
architekci,
lie through
czy z
architecture?
architekturą
We are
nie lubimy
constantly
kłamać?
trying to find a safe place for ourselves, not only from deceitful statements, but also from
Niemniej
falsehood,
jednak,
destroying an
zacytowani przez
idealistic
chwilę
approach to
przez
reality.
Corbusiera architekci, konstruktorzy, nie kłamali świadomie.
Well,
Po prostu reprezentowali inną
architects did
epokę
not lie.
estetyczną.
Architects
Choć byli niemal
that were
rówieśnikami
described in this
Corbusiera.
statement did not
A on
lie.
zafascynowany nową architekturą, własnymi poglądami, uważał, że architektura powoli
And
ustępująca ze sceny jest tak nieszczera, że aż kłamliwa. Przecież Franz ten i Henri Sauvage byli na swój
the
sposób nowocześni.
way we perceive
Jako czołowi
architecture is not always
przedstawiciele estetyki we
consistent with the
Francji
intention of the
pozostawali
author
w
of the
opozycji
building.
architektów
The
wykształconych jakkolwiek
perception
był
of reality, among other things, and on our
jest między
knowledge,
innymi
previous
dom towarowy
experiences
całej
and
tej całości.
sensitivity. In the case of
Od
architecture, we
inwestora otrzymałem zadanie
also
stworzenia jak
are
największej przestrzeni
with
handlowej,
close
co
contact
najniższą możliwą
with it.
cenę, a do tego liczył się czas wznoszenia obiektu. Przywołany Pierre Paquet, absolwent École des Beaux-Arts, choć był wybitnym konserwatorem, jako projektant nie przystawał do nowych czasów. Jedną z jego prac jest m.in. rekonstrukcja L'Hôtel Cluny. Także wywołany przez Corbusiera szwajcarski artysta Jean Grasset uważany jest za pioniera wzornictwa artystycznego okresu secesji. Prawda i fałsz w architekturze.
The truth and false in
W zakochanym
architecture.
świecie nieustannie
In
próbujemy
the world
znaleźć
of lies,
środowisko
we
bezpieczne.
keep on trying
Nie tylko
to
w
find
pełni
our
dobrej
safe
pozycji,
place.
ale również od fałszu,
And we
kurzącego się
want to
czasami zbyt
understand
idealistyczne
the
podejście do
truth
rzeczywistości.
and we think of
Nie
false
do
which
końca
promotes more
uświadamiamy sobie
too much
prawdę, że również
idealistic
oszukuje
concepts
nas
and
także
we
nasz
do not
mózg.
entirely
Chociaż
understand
nasz
that we
jeden,
are also
że oszukiwanie jest
cheated by our
niewątpliwym
own
elementem
mind.
kosztu.
In other
I to nie
words,
tylko w
that
kobietach,
this,
ale
this
również w
illusion
zwierzętach
is
i
a
przyrodzie.
common part of our life,
Czasami budujemy
life of humans,
iluzję
animals
innej
and their nature.
rzeczywistości.
We often use illusion
Historia
to build a
architektury
reality. The
pokazuje
history of
często dla właściwego
architecture
odbioru odwoływamy
often
się do
shows
ilustracji.
how
Pamiętamy
we
doświadczenia
refer to
architektoniczne w
certain
zakresie baroku,
concepts here and we
twórcy
understand
baroku,
and remember how
wykorzystywali
Baroque
malarstwo
was
do
using that
budowania
and the
przepotężniejszego
creators
i
of
bardziej
Baroque
złożonego
they
obrazu
used that
niż była
their
rzeczywistość.
specific style of painting to create
Ale
reality,
jest jeszcze
their
inna strona
reality. But then there is another way of
Paweł
understanding
Picasso,
and considering
sztuka
it.
to
For
kłamstwo,
Picasso,
które pozwala
the art and the
świadomie
lie, which allows to comprehend
pisarze,
the
malarze,
truth
ale
and
nie ma
be aware of the truth.
sztuki
Painters,
w tym biegu, żeby
writers,
zgromadzić nasze zmysły,
but also
ukształtowaną przez
poets,
środowisko,
they want
żeby
to
ukazać
understand
nasz
art through all
świat, który
senses, and they want to show
należy
the universe and the right ways to perceive the reality. So that was about building the reality, the building the world of images, imagination and pictures. So and also the titles of some paintings. So for example, we have that painting Treachery.
Przypomina widzowi, że to,
of
co
the
widzi,
description juxtaposed with the real title shows that this is not the real picture, not the real illustration. So it was believed that the artist, while painting, has the certain power to influence the reality by building the awareness. Every action of an artist is a magic action. A creator, by storytelling, showing images and pictures, transfers us that to the world of his or her creation, moving us to often unreal locations, and it he is an unrealistic and exceptional figure. So we should see things as they are, and we should not see things through the prism of their concepts. So when we see the elephant, we should see the elephant and not the imaginary view. Not all architects lie or try to mislead people, but there are often examples that they're in full awareness want to create an illusion of true expressions. So this is an attempt to recreate the Ponte Rialto bridge. And sometimes architects build houses upside down, or they introduce the new media to create illusion of the reality. But this is only a way of having that interplay with their audience. Cognition in architecture is a process. It is very different than just a simple understanding of a cube. An architecture which should be measured, should be walked through, where architecture should be tactile. It should allow to be for touching, for being close, for understanding the essence of it. Museum and art. Stanisław Fiołkowski, he believed that he wasn't painting for the audience or for a gallery, that he was painting for himself, for his uninterrupted internal intuitive search for the truth. He also believed that art was equally an artistic expression, an abstract expression, and it was not necessarily expressed through truth and lie. But it was expressed by that idealistic approach, and nowadays we can see that his approach was idealistic, and the artist's works, these are tangible and intangible values, and on the market they increasingly become a commodity that ensure profit. Well, museums very often initiate this false game between art and space. Looking at what is happening in the art market, I think that the representatives of the current of art in their manifesto of 1989 recognized that the art which must be the most shown in a gallery is not art. So it was so that would lead to the conclusion that artists who do not paint are not artists, and their movement found followers around the world. They believed so, but then eventually they started to demonstrate their attitude, and they were attracting more and more followers. And finally, they were noticed by galleries and museums, and prices of their works were growing in prices, and their works were popularly acquired by museums. Daniel Durand, a French artist, when defining the key functions of museum, mentions the economic function. This is the function of presenting art in museum. The museum of imagination. A museum is also a building containing a collection, and it could be tangible or intangible. Not always tangible artifacts must build a collection. In 1947, André Marcot, he suggested a new vision of a museum imaginaire, a virtual museum that promoted development of photography and the new media to promote unrestricted growth and of creation. But unfortunately, the direct contact would not be allowed here. The first sentence of with which Marlowe started his book was was controversial. So the Romanesque crucifix was not initially a sculpture. Our Lady with a Child initially was not a painting. Malraux, he reminds everyone that these objects fulfilled certain social functions in the community, and also they could represent certain items or illustrate or portray certain persons, and they did not enjoy the status of a work of art. So nowadays, when we look at masterpieces, we can wonder whether looking at Mona Lisa through a bulletproof wall, pain is not an act of cheating. The way paved by Malraux was followed by all the creators who present works of art and masterpieces on the internet. Nowadays, every single piece of art usually has its own virtual replica. And there was this event in 2017 during the Los Angeles exhibition. Simon Birch, together with a group of artists, they demonstrated an artistic illustration that engages in the process of creation of work in order to collect experience about contemporary art and its impact on the popular engagement. And at some point, that engagement took a very unexpected form. A young girl, she unfortunately stumbled over one of the pieces in the exhibition, which cost $200,000 of losses. Here we have a Japanese exhibition with rooms of unlimited space. The visitors, he stumbled and lost his balance, and when falling, destroyed a part of the exhibition.
Nie trzeba robić selfie, żeby przypadkowo zrobić szkodę, a nawet ulec wypadkowi.
Accidents can happen in museum space. Poważny
wypadek zdarzył się na terenie Fundacji Sir Alves Porto.
Took place in the area of a park near our museum, and it was in 2018. When an installation was displayed inside a concrete cubicle, there was a hole in the ground with vast emptiness representing space, and that looked as an imaginary dark hole, and it trapped one of the visitors. Fell into that hole and he ended up in hospital. So that presents the author's interest and expresses the author's interest in unlimited imaginary concept of never-ending space. So here we also have a new cultural change. Even such distinguished institution as the National Museum in Krakow, organizers such actions as encouraging to make self-portraits in the museum. And here we have a campaign entitled, "This is what our masterpieces do when they think that they are not watched." So this is the museum of new reality, of different reality. The Museum of Other Realities that leave the virtual space to artists, allowing them to create new forms of art. It's a very different reality. The virtual space allows for a continuous enlargement of a location, adapting it to the increasing number of works of art. Well, it could be expanded to an unlimited scale. And then the border between the interior and exterior is blurred, and the wall, which we think is the external wall, turns out to be an internal wall. And here the wall space can be used effectively for art display purposes. And digital opportunities gave us that endless concept, permanent expandable concept of a museum.
Well,
some say that man needs museum to see themselves. So everybody makes selfie, irrespective of circumstances, age, and everybody wants to have these pictures of themselves and those who come with them. But there are some institutions that call themselves museums, but they are not museums. And because of the popularity of selfies made in so many locations, there are selfie museums springing up across the world. If we have that name of a museum in the name of an institution, well, that suggests that this is a very special place for entertainment and a place for fun. Well, I don't think perhaps we should not be, I should think that perhaps we shouldn't be saying that architecture is a lie, that architecture lies. What is a lie in architecture? Or perhaps a lie is just an illusion. It is a being hanging between the lie and the truth. We so often speak about the truth and false and their mutual relations and the difficulty between distinguishing between the two of them. Or perhaps this is about illusion, and perhaps such museums and presentations are even more important and more interesting than the art that they contain. And perhaps this is because they make us feel that we're on the border, we're sitting on a fence between two worlds, the real world and the imaginary world created and invented by artists. I thank you very much for your attention.